Why did you do that? No. When? What? What? Things that fly. Things that jump. Things that play the harmonica. Come on, come on. My celebrity stinks. She's giving me lousy clues. Ooh, 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 ooh. Oh. What a nightmare. That's the last time I ate a whole box of steakums right before bed. This Fraggle Rock.
Oh, Miss Hannah, why don't you just fall right into my burning ring of fire?
Dad, what are you guys doing up so early? I thought retired people were supposed to get as much sleep as possible. You know, to rest up for all the clapping you gotta do to turn the lights on and off.
Gladys, were you smoking heavily when you were pregnant with Chris?
Chris, your father has something very important he wants to talk to you about.
Well, sure, Dad, but I can't be late for work.
That's exactly what I want to talk to you about. You know, son, a couple of years ago, when you moved out of the house into the garage, that was a step in the right direction. Now your mother and I feel like maybe you're in a rut.
We don't think you're really happy, and we don't want to see you turn into some kind of lost soul.
Well, gosh, Ma, you make it sound like I'm going to start sending flowers to Jodie Foster or something.
Jodie Foster, Daryl Hannah.
All right, now, wait a second. I am not obsessed with Daryl Hannah, okay? I just happen to believe that she may very well be one of the greatest American actresses since Lillian Gish. Look, Mom, Dad, journalism, it's in my blood. I love the thrill of it, the excitement of it, the smell of it, the down and dirty, stagnant, stinking stench of it all. Well, I can tell you two understand.
Have a good day at work, son.
Mother, father, I'm off.
Look on the bright side, Gladys. His boss says he's the best man for the job.
Stand in the place where you live.
Now there's no.
Think about direction, wonder why you have it now.
Stand in the place where you were.
Now face well.
Think about the place where you live.
What are you doing here?
Larry, I've come to rescue you from a grueling day at the office and take you out on a fun-filled adventure.
Hey, what a great idea. Get out.
Larry, not doing this for you, pal. The rat race, it's eating you up alive, buddy.
Chris, what do you know about the rat race? You're a paper boy.
Hey, I'm head paper boy, okay? I got 5 guys under me, all right? And when things get tight, I can do other jobs. Larry, look, the point is, there's nothing more important in life than free time.
Forget it. Listen, the last time we went on one of your little adventures, we ran over a pig.
No, no, Larry, that was an accident, and it was not a pig. It was a bag of garbage.
It was a pig! A pig!
Shh!
Larry. Larry, are you talking to me?
No, I'm from the water company, ma'am. We released some mustard sulfites into the water, and, you know, now we're warning people not to bathe. Otherwise, you know, they're gonna smell like mustard.
How interesting. Larry, what is Chris Peterson doing here?
He delivered our paper, honey.
Well, he is not required to deliver it into my bedroom.
Well, that's not what you told the Domino's boy last
night.
Oh, what did I say? It's a joke.
Peterson, you are such a brat. What are you doing here anyway? Shouldn't you be out selling seeds with the Boy Scouts or something?
Oh, ouch, what a zinger!
Incredibly sarcastic and right to the heart comment about my life. Sharon, you've opened my eyes. You've matured me instantly. Hey, you got a Nintendo.
Yeah, the Power Glove, too.
Lawrence cannot play with you right now, Chris. Larry has a real job he's got to get ready for. Right, Lawrence?
Oh, sure, I understand. Hey, listen, Sharon. I brought you something, little gift. This is the new Victoria's Secret catalog. I'm done with it, but I went ahead and I circled some items in here that, well, maybe you should take a look at. Unless, of course, you are more comfortable with the burlap bag look. And don't get me wrong. I really think it looks terrific on you, but
Chris,
yeah, maybe you should.
Yeah. Let me just say this as precisely as I possibly can.
Okay.
You're 30 years old. You still live with your parents. You're losing your hair. And you're stupid. Yeah, you know, I think that just about covers it. Now, I'm going downstairs to make some coffee for Larry.
Larry, I love her. She's a dream. If you ever divorce her, can you please let me know? Because I'd like to, you know, get in there if I could.
Fine, I don't know.
Chris, could you please tell me why you and Sharon have to fight all the time?
Gee, I don't know. Maybe we're frustrated because we're secretly in love with each other.
But I doubt it, Larry. I really doubt it.
Come on, let's go.
Forget it. I can't take the day off. Things are crazy down at Bushman and Simon. And ever since old man Simon got drunk and rode his horse into the mall, we've been losing customers right and left. Now, we're under the gun to come up with new clients or else. I can't just live like you and hang out with Wally and the Beeve and bug Mr. Wilson.
Okay, Larry, but I just happen to have 2 tickets to the Funland Amusement Park, Larry. And, well, they're unveiling today for the first time the first 360-degree super roller coaster in Minnesota, Larry. Larry, it's the Hell Loop 2000.
The Hell Loop 2000? I heard about that.
Mm-hmm.
No. No way. I can't just skip off on a whim whenever I want. I've got responsibilities. It really does a complete loop?
Uncle Chris! WrestleMania!
WrestleMania!
Oh, hi, Daddy. I need to notice you over there. Bobby and I are gonna play with your power glove, okay?
Okay, fine.
Okay, fine. What am I saying? No, it's not okay, fine. This is my Nintendo. Understand me? Mine, mine, mine.
Gosh, Dad, don't bust a blood vessel over it. Mama.
Okay, maybe I have been a little tense lately, at least with the kids.
Larry, you're exactly the person they built the Hell Loop 2000 for.
Chris, I can't go. Even if I wanted to, I can't get out of work on such short notice.
Okay, leave that to me. I'll just call your office and pretend I'm you.
Are you crazy?
Now, relax. Listen, I'm a master of mimicry. I've got you down perfectly.
Yeah, how you doing? This is Lawrence T. Potter III. Yeah, who you be? Lorraine? Yeah, all right. Well, Lorraine, you dig this. I got some cold, see? And my uncle, he died. Yeah, so I got to go to the funeral, you dig? Yeah, so I ain't gonna be dragging my sorry old butt in there today. Yeah, you pass that on. All right, baby, later for you. There, it's done.
You just got me fired, you idiot.
Will you relax? Your voice is very guttural, and I think I captured that quality marvelously. You're a free man. Come on, let's go.
I'm not going. Chris, look, you'll always be my best friend, but we're not children anymore. And you can't manipulate me like you used to.
Okay. I understand. You're chicken.
All right, that's it. I'm in. Let's go.
Oh, well, we apologize for our enthusiastic wooing, sir, but as you can tell, your ride brings us great joy.
You've been on this thing 5 times. You getting off?
Just what the hell does that mean, you filth?
Chris, he's asking if we're done, if we're getting off the ride.
Oh, pardon me. I'm sorry. I thought that you thought that, well, Larry and I were lovers or something.
Now, why would I think a thing like that?
Well, 2 men on a roller coaster giggling like schoolgirls, you could easily get the wrong impression, I guess. Yeah, right. We are going to go one more time, so let her rip.
Actually, Chris, you know, it's getting late. But you were right about today. I feel a lot less tense. Thanks.
Well, Larry, the only way to thank me is to ride the loop one more time. Come on, one more time, one more time.
All right, one more time, and that's it.
All right,
let her go. Woo, 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 woo,
woo, woo, woo, woo. Weenies.
Okay, here we go. Here we go, through the loop. Here we go, you bloody bastard!
Larry, are we moving through the loop a lot slower this time?
It's probably just a temporary malfunction. I bet we'll be moving in no more than 2 seconds.
I bet you're right. Larry, we're stuck.
It's jam! Oh, no, I'll be back dipping funnel cakes in the deep fry by tomorrow. We'll have you down in no time. Hold on to your pants.
Did he just ask us where we bought our pants at a time like this? The Gap, you idiot. Now get us down.
Chris, today was supposed to be relaxing. It was supposed to be fun. Instead, I'm stuck in a bad Irwin Allen movie with an aging Dennis the Menace.
All right. Just relax, okay? I know you're frightened, Larry, but I promise you I will get us through this thing, okay? Just relax. Oh. There's got to be a morning after. Ah, it's waiting right outside the door. Ah.
Watergate was really bad. The movie Brian song was kind of sad. Playing Pac-Man at the mall. China under martial law. Gorbachev comes to town. Chris and Larry upside down. We didn't start the fire. It was all.
Shut up! I can't take it anymore. I'm gonna rip out your vocal cords and stuff them in your ear.
Are you getting a little cranky?
Yes, I'm getting cranky. We've been upside down for 2 hours already.
Yeah, and that kind of brings up an interesting point. I wonder how long it takes before all the blood rushes to your brain and your head explodes.
Why is this taking so long? Don't they realize this thing could fall at any second?
Larry, don't be ridiculous. This is a state-of-the-art roller coaster. It's been tested, double-tested, and triple-tested. We're perfectly safe.
Well, in retrospect, what we should have done is tested this thing. Obviously, that car could fall off the track any second now. We'll have to act fast. Henderson, call Thrill World. Find out how they handle their dead.
I just want to go home. Home to my kids and my dear, sweet wife.
Dear, sweet wife? Hey, pal, I don't know what you're smoking over there, but I think it's distorting your sense of reality.
Shut up. You're such an idiot.
Yeah, well, has it ever occurred to you that I'm happy being an idiot, Mr. 9 to 1?
Chris, it's 9 to 5, not 9 to 1.
Wow, you really put in the hours there, don't you?
Wait, what was that? Oh, we're gonna die up here. We're gonna die.
Don't say that, Larry. Don't say that. All right, listen. We need to keep our strength. Let's eat. We need to ration what little food we have here.
Would you like some Doritos? Crunch all you want. We'll make more. That is so cool.
All fixed.
What are they yelling at us?
Oh, well, they're just shouting, you know, words of encouragement, best wishes, and so forth, that sort of thing. Now, that's kind of odd.
Chris, I must be hallucinating. I think I see an angel.
That's no angel, Larry. That's Connie Bristol from WRXT-TV. We're saved, Larry. We're saved.
Thank God. Wait a second, TV. We're not going to be on TV, are we?
Well, sure, we're kind of like those whales that were stuck in the ice.
What if somebody sees me? Everybody at work thinks I'm at a funeral.
Oh, yeah. Well, quick, hide.
Where the hell am I supposed to hide?
Would you two idiots please shut up? We're about to go on the air. Hello, I'm Connie Bristol reporting from Funland Amusement Park. And suspended, upside down behind me, are two very brave men whose lives may end at any moment. Hi, guys, you want to tell us your names?
Connie, do you think maybe we could do the interview down on the ground?
I asked... Your names?
Hey, Mom, look! Uncle Chris and Daddy on TV! Cool!
Well, I'm Chris Peterson, and this is my friend Larry Potter.
Ladies and gentlemen, it appears as though the roller coaster is about to tear off the track and plummet to the hard concrete below right now during my exclusive report. Well, I guess not. And now let's go back to our studios, where Dr. Charles Friedman will tell us how long a person can hang upside down before their head explodes.
Connie, wait, don't go. You can use your crane thing to get us down.
Sorry, reporters have to stay objective. We just can't get involved with our stories. Bye.
Come back! Come back! Come back, you ratings-grabbing whore! Slut!
Larry, get a grip on yourself, Larry. I'm thinking clearer now than I've ever thought before in my life, and you know what? It's so simple. All we have to do is unstrap ourselves, get out of the car, and climb down the track rung by rung, hand over hand.
You're insane. That'll never work. Where's that slut? That whore!
Larry, please. Listen, I wouldn't try this unless I was in peak physical condition, but, you know, if you don't feel like you're up to it, then just grab a hold of my love handles, and I'll carry you down. Larry? Larry, I think I miscalculated. Larry, we are gonna die.
Goodbye, Chris.
Larry, I love you. Not, you know, in a strange way, more like a brother, although, you know, at this point, why should we rule anything out? Goodbye, my friend. Goodbye.
Wait, Chris, we're moving. We're moving. Don't let go.
Oh, praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Here we go. Through the loop. Through the loop.
All right, it's fixed.
One more time. One more time.
Get out of there, you wieners.
Okay. That's odd.
I'm dead. There's my boss, Mr. Simon.
Okay, don't worry. He's just here with his kid. He didn't see us. Let's go this way, Larry. Okay, that's not gonna be good either.
What are you doing here? I thought you had a cold and a funeral to go to today.
Well, yes, sir. After the funeral, I came here to the amusement park to buy some Dristan.
Uh-huh. Potter, you're fired.
Now, hold on just a doggone second here.
Who's this jerk?
Well, I am a southern multi-billionaire, and you see, this fella here was just trying to convince me to bring my little company to your accounting firm.
Oh, shut up. What do you take me for, an imbecile?
Well, actually, yes, sir, I do take you for an imbecile. I'm sorry, but that's just a problem I'm going to have to work out on my own. But if I could just have a second of your time. Everybody, listen up here. Connie, come over here. I want you to hear this, too. My friend, Larry Potter, has just been fired by this man. But I suggest to all of you that perhaps he deserves a second chance? Who among us hasn't been given a second chance just once in their miserable lives? Well, I know someone who was given a second chance, an overworked president of a major accounting firm who had a little too much Jim Beam one night and decided to take a joyride through JCPenney's on Mr. Ed. It took several months, but eventually we all stopped snickering behind his back. And so, if we can forgive the lovable town lush, can't we forgive one of his underlings? Who, after all, was merely trying to relieve some of the incredible pressure in his life so that tomorrow he could do his job that much better. Potter! Potter! If you ever pull a stunt like this again, you'll be out like yesterday's garbage. I'll see you in the morning. Well, Larry, all in all, kind of a fun day, huh?
Oh, boys.
Oh, no. She's really mad, I can tell. I'm dead.
All right, don't worry, Larry. I know just how to sweet talk Sharon. You leave this to me. Sharon, hi, how are you? Hey, listen, just a little constructive criticism. Maybe before you leave the house in the morning, you should try dabbing on a little makeup. Maybe that would help.
Chris!
Yeah?
Do you realize I'm in position to thrust my knee upward with great passion and velocity?
Let me get this straight, Sharon. You're coming on to me with your husband standing right over there?
Come along home now, Lawrence. We have a busy evening ahead of us.
Yes, dear. If you don't hear from me in a couple days, call Robert Stack over at Unsolved Mysteries.
Yeah, sure. Hey, great, there's still no line for this thing. Okay, one more time, Chief, through the loop. Let's go, let her rip. Woo! Woo! Oh, hi, Ma. Hi, Dad.
So, how was your day?
I guess it was okay. I was hanging upside down on a roller coaster for about 8 hours.
Clap off the lights before you go to bed, will you, son?
Gladys, I was reading an interesting article on chromosome damage.
That is so cool.